Hi, my name is Matt Siddall, and in today's video tech tip, we're going to be looking at taking imported geometry, in this case, a toggle clamp that was downloaded as a SOLIDWORKS part, and converting it so that it is optimized to work in your assemblies. One of the most important things that we're going to be looking at today is going to be in our options and our document properties. As downloaded, this particular toggle clamp has the image quality set extremely high, which we're going to turn down. And we'll be setting this down as well. This wireframe and high quality resolution has less of an impact, but the shaded and draft quality is a massive drain on resources, will increase your file size if it's set too high, and is also going to increase your loading time. Not only is it important to turn it down in this part, but when we get into future steps where we're going to be converting this into subparts where needed, or sub-assemblies where needed, we need to make sure that our part and assembly file templates are also set to these lower standards. Okay, so at this point, this is one of the, like I said, this is the most important step that we've done. If this is a more simplistic part where you don't need to do anything else with this, you can go ahead and save this file out and be happy with where you're at. In this case, we have a toggle clamp. Maybe this is something that we want to reconstruct and turn into something that's going to be having an open and closed position. We're going to do a little bit more manipulation. One thing that we are definitely going to want to take care of is this bolt. Threads are at least non-cosmetic. Actually modeled in threads are another significant impact on model file size and load times, even with low image quality. You may have noticed that I've got my direct editing tab opened up here, and we're going to be using this to break this assembly into multiple parts. As I mentioned, we're going to start with the actual bolt foot here. I just need to figure out which bodies that it is. Let me get a face here. So 8 and 9. Let's try and get these. And we can go ahead and isolate this. And what we are going to do initially is we're going to find a sketch plane here. I think the right plane is good. Yep. And we're going to go ahead and create a sketch on here. And we are going to kind of delete these threads. There's some different ways that you can go about this. There are defeature tools inside of SOLIDWORKS that can help with something like this. Just for simplicity's sake, I'm just going to do a basic revolve and get that taken care of this way. Throw a quick dimension in here so we're not underdefined. And if we go about this the right way, we should be able to get two things done with one step here, where we're going to have merge result active. So we can accept that. Sketch isn't quite right, so let me quickly adjust that. Okay. For our purposes, that's close enough. Ideally, we'd be trying to get rid of the threads entirely, and we can go ahead and exit isolate. If we come back out, we'll notice that those two imported bodies are no longer here, and we now have a single revolve one. What we're going to do next is find something like one of these nuts, and we can isolate that. Fortunately, the nut doesn't have any threads in it, so we can skip that, but it's good to check. And let's see what we got. So at this point, we can do a combine because we're going to want this nut and washer tied together in our model. We only need to do this with the one, and we can combine that. The idea being to reduce our number of bodies to only the maybe pairs of components or groups of components that we're going to compare, care about. I'm going to be right back with the model completed and with everything combined as will be necessary for the next steps. Okay, so at this point I have combined everything relevant for what we're going to be doing moving forward, and I also went ahead and fixed those threads. So the next thing that we're going to be looking at is using the split tool. Nice thing about the split tool is that we can come in here and select our templates. Again, a reminder that your templates should be set up in a way where the graphic settings are low so that you don't need to go in and edit the part files after the fact. But what we're going to do with the split tool is we can select a face or plane that will not actually intersect any of our subcomponents. So when I go ahead and cut bodies, all the split tool is going to do is recognize that we have multiple bodies and not actually manipulate any of them. At this point, we can go in and save each of these discrete files to have our individual part files, which I'll go ahead and do now. Okay, so at this point, I have saved out all of our independent files, and what we have here is the base of the toggle clamp. A quick thing to mention that is going to be important is coming into external references. You're going to want to, for performance sake, either lock all or break all external references. Be mindful that break all cannot be undone, so I have a tendency to lock all, even on things I don't need to potentially ever come back in and make edits. I'm going to go ahead and close this, and I've actually went ahead and mated in all of my subcomponents and set up a configuration so that I have this as both open and closed. And now my file is ready to be used in an assembly without having a significant impact on both my file size and performance. Anyway, I hope this has been helpful. Thanks for watching.